Okay. Dear Chairman, dear colleagues, I'm going to introduce to your attention the presentation on the specificity of the foreign shell type nanocomposites formation under the rotation corrosion dispergation condition. The biomedical application of gold and silver nanoparticles, as well as ferrimagnetic nanoparticles, magnetite and magnemite, has been well known within the last 20 years. At the same time, the appearance of a new kind of nanomaterials, especially foreign shell type nanocomposites, enhance the practical usage of such structures due to the combination of both physicochemical properties, core and shell materials. In general, foreign shell type nanocomposites are formed via the interaction of specially formed core and shell species by the means of organic substances or reducing of shell species on the cores or performing one-stage redox reaction. Recently, we have proposed a new method of the obtaining of nanoparticles, ferrimagnetic nanoparticles, including core and shell type structure on the steel surface in the open air systems that was called the rotation corrosion dispergation. The principal scheme of the RCD equipment are seen in this slide. We use the rotating disc electrode made of steel 3 to the performing on the phase formation process. The alternate contact of the steel surface with water dispersion medium and air or other gases permits to regulate of oxidative condition in the system. Furthermore, the design of cells provides for the regulation of the temperature conditions in the system. As this was found in our experimental data, the presence of other components in the steel, except iron, do not influence on the chemical and phase composition of the obtained particles. In general, electrochemical process performed in our system includes the specially separated half reaction of the iron ionization in the anode section of the steel and oxygen depolarization in the cathode part of the steel surface. In first case, in the system, the ferrous iron is supplied, and in second case, the hydroxyl. Protons, oxygen, carbon dioxide act as an other active components in the system, in the process of the phase formation. The schematic image of the reaction area is present in the slide. It wide does not exceed 400 micrometer. So the primary mineral phase formed on the steel surface contacted with distilled water and air oxygen within 1 or 3 hours is hydroxycarbonate, ferric ferrous layer double hydroxide or green rust. The presence of ferrous iron in the greener slices make it unstable against the following oxidation, and the products of the and such structure may easily broken under oxidative conditions. So the products of the solid stage green rust oxidation strongly depends on the pH value in the system. It may be X green rust or ferric green rust or lepidocrasite. By the dissolution reprecipitation process leads to the formation of magnetite particles. But in our case, the most interesting to the green rust structure is closely connected with the strong reductive properties. To obtain of core and shell type nanocomposite, we chose the argentum nitrate solution in the wide range of the argentum concentration from the 1/2 to 20 milligrams per cubic decimeter, and a fuel solution containing aurum 1 and 20 milligrams per cubic decimeter and platinum and palladium. the physico-chemical methods used in our study includes the X-ray diffraction, X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy, wet chemistry and chemical analysis, magnetometry, atomic force and magnetic force microscopy, scanning and transmission electron microscopy. So, the XRD patterns is seen in this slide. The argentum bearing samples are present in the top, and other precious metal, aurum, platinum, and palladium are seen in the bottom. In all cases, we can see the strong reflexes of magnetite, the core material, and a small peaks of precious metal, the shells material. And iron oxyhydroxide, especially lepidactoside, appear in the system as an additional mineral phase. So the formation of such structures significantly complicates the practical usage of the core and shell bearing zones formed via the rotation corrosion dispergation route. At the same time, the gold, the precious metal peaks are small because its content in the initial water dispersion medium lies in detection limit of the XRD method. The primary particle size of magnetite work was calculated according to the Debye-Sherrer's formula. It's made from 18 to 24 for magnetite precious metal, except the argentum bearing samples, where the coherent scattering region of magnetite is gradually growing from 19 to 28, when the argentum concentration is increased from half one to 20 milligram per cubic decimeter. X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy permits us to estimate the metal distribution in the composite samples. The mass percent of precious metal in the composite particles will correlate with the initial concentration in the water dispersion medium. And as we can see in the graph, it's gradually growing up to 15 milligram per cubic decimeter. Generally, it varies from several hundreds to several tens, mass percent. The next slide shows us the TEM images of composite salts. In top argentum bearing samples and gold, platinum, and palladium bearing samples at the bottom. So, the spherical particles in argentum and aurum bearing system corresponds to the core and shell type nanocomposites, whereas this needle-like to lepidactoside. In the presence of platinum and palladium, the composite particles are characterized by anisometrical shape. One of the interesting questions is corresponds to the shell structure. Depending on the precious metal concentration, the shell may form metal clusters. Form metal clusters on the magnetite surface, as well as a full or porous shell, as we can see in the dark and light field images. The magnetite grains covered with silver are present in the photo. Individual composite particles are sufficiently homogeneous, and their size will correlate with coherent scattering region of the magnetite core. But such particles may form a small percent of aggregates in an average size 1 or 200 nanometers. The aggregates include a few composite particles. At the same time, the cores of composite may form not only a single particle, but from 3 to 5, and we deal with polynuclear composites. When the rotating corrosion dispurgation method is applied, the current shell type nanocomposites may form not only in the water dispersion medium in the reaction area, but on the steel surface as well. The CEM images help us to see such structure. In all cases, they are characterized by spherical or close to cubical shape, and they form aggregates that may be easily broken under the minor mechanical impact. The next slide demonstrates us the atomic force microscopy images. All particles have close to spherical shape, and all particles have nanosizes. But more informative is the next slide, because we can see the magnetic force microscopy images. Hence, all our composite particles show magnetic response that corresponds to magnetic core, magnetite. The following magnetic investigation using magnetometry help us to determine the influence of shells on the magnetic properties of composite materials. So we chose magnetite silver nanoparticles formed at initial argentum concentration 1/2 and 5 mg/cm. And despite the fact that in all cases we obtain the magnetically soft materials, the particles belong to the superparamagnetic. One of the main magnetic parameters, saturation magnetization, decreased from 0.4 to 0.25 mO per gram when the argentum concentration is increased. Coercitivity of both samples is 500 per step, and the remaining magnetization in both samples is 0.03 mO per gram. We use the differences in the magnetic properties of magnetite and lepidocrasite to separate our biphasic zones. So because the magnetite belongs to the ferrimagnetic or superparamagnetic particles, and lepidocrasite is paramagnetic only. The products of this separation are present in the slide. To determine the mechanism of the formation of current shell type nanocomposites, we obtain the kinetic regularities of precious metals binding from the solutions in the wide range of initial concentration. As this is well seen, at higher concentration, 10 milligrams per cubic decimeter, the curves have changes that correspond to formation of magnetite core, probably doped with precious metals. At the first stage, and reducing the residual precious metal aqua forms from solution on the surface of magnetite in the second stage. The second stage accompanied by the formation of additional lepidocrasite phase. Our supposition was confirmed by the calculation of corresponding thermodynamical functions. But now I do not bring here the complete results, but Gibbs free energy only, of the reaction only. So the formation of biphasic system is preferential under the RCD conditions. And the last question is about the practical application of current shell type structure formed in our system. So, we have tested some composites in the biological environment and found that argentum-bearing samples composites caused the free radical generating process, whereas the orum-bearing one would rather inhibit them. The broadband light source of 500 to 650 nanometer in fluorescence spectral form bearing nanocomposites are attributed to the surface plasmonic resonance. The occurrence of plasmonic peaks shifted to a far red frequency range, probably due to the score association, is most remarkable finding as it fits with so-called transparency window for a body issues. And last, the magnetite argentum bearing nanocomposites show the antimicrobial activity experiments of gram-positive and gram-negative bacterial cultures, and they have good prospects for the development of the novel anti-infection agents. And our conclusions. The presence of precious metal aqua forms in the water dispersion medium contacting with green rust layer formed on the steel surface under the rotation corrosion dispergation condition permits to form corn shell type nanocomposites. The structure includes the ferrimagnetic core magnetite and precious metal shells, gold, silver, platinum, or palladium. The usage of magnetic separation helps to remove an additional oxyhydroxide space from the composite zones. The obtained corn shell type nanocomposites show biological activity and they have good prospects for their medical application as a platform for molecular therapeutic and development of novel anti-infection agent. Thank you for your attention.
Any questions?